we have even more Modern Horizons 2 combos for today. I know that we're already 4 videos into the new set, but...
In the words of Princess Kate, after we came back from our shopping trip in Ibiza, there's a lot to unpack here.
For our first combo, we have Timeless Witness. She's the same as Eternal Witness, but costs 1 more mana, and you can Eternalize her for 7. Costing 1 more mana is a huge downside, and at first, I thought the Timeless Witness's Eternalize ability didn't really make up for it. After all, paying 7 mana to get 1 card back from your graveyard is a terrible rate. But then I realized something. The important part of the Eternalize ability isn't that it gets you back a card. The important part is that you get to make a token copy of Timeless Witness. Green is incredible at token synergies with cards like Parallel Lives and Doubling Season. But the best mechanic to use here is a slightly more obscure one, Populate. Populate just means make a copy of a creature token, and it synergizes perfectly with Timeless Witness. Let's say we have a Timeless Witness token, and then we cast Sundering Growth. We get to destroy an artifact or enchantment, and then we make a copy of our Timeless Witness. Now the Timeless Witness's trigger won't go on the stack until Sundering Growth finishes resolving and goes to the graveyard, so we can use the ability to target Sundering Growth and put it back into our hand. So as long as we have this combo set up, we can just pay 2 mana as many times as we want to make a 4-4 and destroy an artifact or enchantment. The only bad news here is that Sundering Growth is the only really good Populate card, but there are a couple others that are okay. We could use Wake the Reflections to just spam 4-4 tokens for 1 mana each, or maybe Druid's Deliverance to turbo fog people. And if we want to take a quick trip to Magical Christmas Land, then Timeless Witness with Song of the World Soul is just absolutely insane. Also, if you're playing a Populate commander like Tristani or Ghirid, then Timeless Witness would be great there as well. These two cards are going to be in hot contention fighting over deck slots, but I think it's pretty clear now which one's the better choice.
Looks like what we got here is a standoff.
Not really.
Next up, we have 2 different cards from the set. Ave, Progenitor Ooze, and Chatterstorm. I'm really glad that green is finally getting playable storm cards, because I feel like it just doesn't have anything good and unique to set it apart from the other colors. So it's great to see Wizards providing them with new tools.
It's not easy being green, having to spend each day the color of the leaves.
Seriously though, green is my favorite color, and even I have to admit that they're getting a little too much favoritism here, at least in Commander. But anyways, now that we have good green storm cards, we need to find a way to generate infinite storm in mono green. There are probably a bunch of ways to do it, but the best way I've found is with Quirion Ranger and Ashaya. Quirion Ranger lets us put a forest back in our hand to untap a creature, but only once a turn, and Ashaya makes all of our creatures into forests. So if we have them both on the board, then we can return Quirion Ranger to our hand using her own ability since she's currently a forest. That lets us untap Ashaya, who we can then tap for 1 mana. We use that mana to play the Quirion Ranger again, and since she left the board and came back, we can reuse her ability. This combo doesn't actually do anything by itself, but I think it's the easiest way to generate infinite storm in green, and then we can just play one of our green storm cards to try and win. It also helps that Quirion Ranger and Ashaya are both already really good cards, so you won't feel bad putting these in your deck. Last up, we have Dermotaxi, a bus made out of a dead mammoth. Even though this card has the vehicle type, it doesn't have a traditional crew ability. Instead, when you play it, you exile a creature card from a graveyard, and then you can tap 2 creatures to make the Dermotaxi into a copy of that card for a turn, but it's still an artifact vehicle. The easiest thing we can do with this card is discard some giant creature like Ulamog, then play the Dermotaxi and hit people with it. We can also use this to get around ETB effects for cards like Phage the Untouchable. But I don't want to just use this card as a weird reanimation spell, so I found 2 ways to utilize Dermotaxi's ability even better. For our first combo, we're going to need Magda, Brazen Outlaw, and Clock of Omens. Magda makes a treasure whenever we tap a dwarf, and she can also tutor out artifacts, which can help set up our combo. Clock of Omens just lets us tap two artifacts to untap an artifact. Let's say we have Magda in our graveyard and then we Dermotaxi her. If we use the Dermotaxi's ability, then we will have a Magda that also happens to still be an artifact. Now we can use the Clock's ability. We tap Magda and the Clock to untap Magda, which makes us a treasure. Now we can tap Magda and the treasure we just made to untap Magda again and make another treasure. Repeating this process lets us get infinite treasures, which we can then sack to Magda to tutor out every artifact and dragon in our deck. This combo would be a little risky to run in a Magda deck because you would have to exile your own Magda to the Dermotaxi's imprint ability, and letting your commander get exiled is a pretty all-in strategy. Nevertheless, this combo is powerful, and the fact that it only uses Magda and artifacts does make it more consistent. Also, even if you're not going for the combo, Dermotaxi and Clock of Omens are just good cards in a Magda deck. Dermotaxi gives you an easy way to tap your dwarves, and Clock of Omens is a great card to have when you have a bunch of treasure tokens. Our next Dermotaxi combo is a little more complicated. To pull this one off, we need to use Belladross Witherbloom. Belladross has an ability that says, pay 10 life, untap all your lands, but you can only use it once each turn. Let's say that we imprinted Belladross onto our Dermotaxi, and we have 6 random creatures on the board. We can tap the 6 creatures to activate Dermotaxi's ability 3 times. When Dermotaxi becomes Belladross the first time, we can pay 10 life to untap all our lands. Then, when Dermotaxi copies Belladross again, we have a new copy of Belladross that hasn't used its ability yet, so we can pay 10 life again to untap all our lands a second time. This is like a much better version of the combo we did a couple videos ago, where we used Garth and Mirror of the Forebears.
Wanna see
copy that commander?
You wanna see me do it again? Wanna see me
use that combo?
You wanna see me do it again?
If we finish our combo and do it a third time, then that means we paid 30 life to untap all of our lands 3 times. Paying 30 life is a huge cost, but if you can untap all of your lands 3 times, then there's a decent chance you can just win. Technically, we can replace Belladross with any other expensive creature that has a really powerful ability that we can only activate once a turn, and it can't be a tap ability since we can only tap the Dermotaxi once. The sad thing is, I couldn't find a single other creature that fit that description. But I did find a suitable substitute. Patron of the Orochi can tap to untap all forests and green creatures. This is a tap ability, but Patron's ability untaps itself since it's a green creature. If you're playing mono forests, then you might want to run Patron instead of Belladross so that you won't have to pay any life for this combo. It's trivia time. The question from last week was, can you guess what this card does just from the art? And the answer is, this card is a 1-mana blue aura called Flight that just gives a creature flying. I won't be too picky, so if your guess had anything to do with giving a creature flying, then go ahead and give yourself a tofu point. I love how this art just looks like someone took a PNG of a random zebra and pasted it over some drone footage. Now for this week's question. Last video, we poked fun at the fact that Wizards brought back some mechanics in the set that they kinda said they wouldn't. It turns out that there's an unofficial scale made by Mark Rosewater called the Storm Scale, named after the Storm mechanic, and it ranks mechanics from 1 to 10 on how likely they are to make a return to Magic. So if something has a 1, then it's definitely coming back, and if something has a 10, then it is never ever coming back ever, except maybe it might someday. Storm cards and artifact lands were both at a 10, and they came back in this set, so never say never. But there is exactly one mechanic on this list that is so universally hated that it's actually ranked at an 11. Can you guess what it is? What mechanic from Magic's history is never, ever, ever coming back ever, no matter what, according to the Storm Scale, which is a completely unofficial document that means nothing? Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you don't want to miss the answer in the next video or the new spoiler cards. And do all the other YouTube stuff if you like the content. Tofu out.